And to further the conversation on the signing of the bill, we are now joined by legal practitioner Olatunji Salau. Good afternoon, Mr. Salau.
Good afternoon.
Thank you for joining us.
Thank you.
Now, what would be the arguments for and against this new law, if I may ask you?
The bill, the signing to law of bills that seem to tend to eradicate the payment of pension to public officers in Imo State, particularly the governors, the past governors, the deputy governor, the speakers, and the other principal officer, is something that has been we welcome development for a long time. It has generated a lot of controversy all the time. The issue is somebody who worked for maybe 4 years or less, and then you put them in, at the expenses of the citizens, that is taxpaying citizens, for life. Some of them might do well, some of them might not have even done well. It is indeed something that has generated controversy. If you recall, sometimes ago, some people in Kogi State went to court in respect of it, about the Among Us thing. So this bill from Imo State Assembly is certainly something that should be looked at critically and commended. If every state and of the nation can emulate it as a sacrifice that our political officers, office holders, have to make for in the interest of the people they serve, I think it is right. Public office is different from civil service. Civil service, by law, by constitution, is a personable institution. However, public is for a pleasure, a term. And when you are in that office, you have a mandate with the people. In that, you get all your remunerations. But once you leave that office, apart from maybe they pay you the gratuity for service, but to go ahead and be paid life pension for just 3 years of service is really injustice to the system and to the general public at large. All right. So in that light, I say that I've not seen anything unconstitutional on it, and I think the Imo State Assembly has taken the bull by the horn this time around.
All right, there are concerns about the timing of the new law. Those against it say it is an unfair treatment for those who have served the state, while those who are for it say with the new pandemic, every penny is needed. What side of the divide are you on?
Yes, I'm on the side that even without the emergency situation caused by the pandemic around, that it is in the interest of state to eliminate all those wasteful spending. And as far as to a position of governor or whatever, the politics office is supposed to have an alternative office address. So when they leave office, they should be able to go back to that, the what they have been practicing before, and no law prevented them from doing that anyway. So it is in the interest of the economy that such things should stay. So I am on the side that with or without the even the endemic, it has been a strain and a bane on the development of states in the Federation.
All right. We know that some governors and state speakers move on to the National Assembly or get a national appointment. Do you expect a fight from those not in this cadre, you know, affected by this new law in the coming days?
Well, I won't expect anybody to fight it, because, like I said, those who are there currently, they got it. I'm sure those who are not yet there, they will look for an opportunity to get there some other time. And then it's a public service, a service, we call it, it's a service to the nation and to your people, and not to at the expense of the people and the living at this, where you cannot even pay the pensioner who have put all their life into the service of the same state. So whether you get an opportunity to get a higher appointment or not, servicing the state for a period of time under the constitution which you agree to, and once you completed that office, then you should find another things to do. You don't need to live at the expense of the government at all the time. So that is my humble view in respect of that.
All right. right. Legal practitioner Latunji Salawu, thank you so very much for your time with us on News on the Hour.
Thank you so much. It's my pleasure being here. Thank you.